Troy. Great to have you here. Now, you have been Watford's top scorer on four separate occasions. You've helped them with promotion to the Premier League, captained them in an FA Cup final. You're certainly a player who doesn't lack passion. I think it's also fair to say you're known as being a bit of a hard man. Is there anything that actually scares you?
Yeah, there's two things. So, needles, scared of needles, which everyone's looking at me with tattoos, I know, but I'm scared of needles.
So are they just transfers?
Yeah. Sick ones. And snakes, petrified of snakes. So don't ask me why. Never encountered one. But my missus took me to, like, conquer my fears and all of that. Yeah.
Where to?
You got to hold it and then...
Safari park.
So I was like, oh, yeah, it's like this little thing came out. I was like, oh, that's all right. As I'd done that, the geezer's just bought this big 15-foot yellow thing, and I was like, oh my God, yeah. There was a little bit of poo coming out.
if the snake had seen you on a football pitch, I think the snake might have been joining you as well. So
it was panicky, yeah.
But I thought I was all right. We did a charity thing for some kids recently, and there was a lot of animals there you could hold and things, and they passed me a snake, and I went, I'm all right, you know. and I've held it and stuff, and I was like, I just didn't fancy it.
But they're not going to give you one that's going to kill you, are they?
I just thought, I don't need to, do I? I didn't really fancy it.
But when you're talking about being scared of needles, looking at all the ink, which is all over you, is it not those needles?
No, I see. Drawing blood.
Right, yeah.
Do you have to give a lot of blood as a footballer?
Yeah, obviously with drug testers as well, and... Yeah, every time it's a T-shirt off, I can't see. As long as I can't see the needle, I'm all right.
I'm like that, though.
Hands go, start going dizzy, everything.
Yeah. Have you ever fainted?
Yeah.
Have you?
A couple of times.
Oh, here we go, big tough man Troy Deeney.
That's how it is.
As a manager, I wouldn't put a centre-half against you, I'd just put a nurse.
Your road to get to the Premier League, obviously, it's been a bit of an up-and-down road. Like, you started non-league, is that right? You had a job?
Yeah, I'm a qualified builder.
Oh, well, it's good of you to turn up, then.
Look at that chance about that.
Because halfway through this show, you're going to go and do another show.
This is price work, it's all right. I did that and I just used to play, just with my pals on a Saturday and stuff. But the thing that people find it funny is on a Saturday, my mum just kicks everyone out of the house. It's like the cleaning day. So I got sacked from my job on the Friday. Like, it come to an end and we didn't have any work. And my mum literally went out the house, come on, I'm cleaning. And I was like, hungover. I was like, oh, might as well play football then. And then literally the Warsaw Scout happened to be there.
No, let's put this in context. You weren't, like, your mum didn't go, get out of the house, and you go, OK, I'll play football. You were a decent footballer. It's not like
I've always been all right, but it was genuinely that.
So where were you playing when you...
Just locally, so it's Midland Combination 2, so it's like 18 levels
so
below.
You're totally not semi-professional or anything. You were not being
paid. No, I was paying £10 to play.
You paid to play?
Yeah.
How old were you?
18.
So then the Walsall scout?
Yeah, so after the game, I scored a few goals. We won and whatever. And he's just like, oh, do you fancy coming to Walsall? But I didn't actually know where Walsall was at this point. I've never travelled outside of Birmingham, so I was like...
You've never left Birmingham?
Nah, not at that point, nah.
You know it's... there. Like, Birmingham's
no,
here.
No, where it is now, obviously. Yeah, no, it's literally... But I'm from a Campton State background, so we didn't have the luxury of doing that. I went on my first holiday when I was 16, so we didn't have the luxuries of that. We went, like, Tenerife or somewhere like that.
Oh, so you have been out of Birmingham then?
Yeah, flew out. I didn't drive out there.
Do
But, yeah, so the geezer's gone, like, do you want to come and have a trial? And I was like, yeah, whatever, mate, no problem. And I kind of just dismissed it and went in, had a beer, went out, went and played Sunday League the next day with my pals again, went out again, and then went home because I didn't have a job. So I was just like, the door's banging. And I genuinely thought it was like bailiffs. So I thought, oh, we haven't paid the bill or something. Just looked out the window, going, what's happening, mate? He goes, oh, you got that trial now? I was like, that was real. I was like, yeah.
He came for you.
He come and got me, and I got my boots in an Asda bag. Not even my boots, I had to borrow them off my friend's boots. said, Shaz down the side. So anyone sees a picture of me playing for Warsaw, there's a big Shaz, it says down the side. My name's not Shaz, if anyone does. Stayed there and the rest is history.
So who was this guy?
The guy who dropped me there, Mick Elsa was the one who picked me, and the guy who dropped me there was Derek from the local club.
Still known?
Yeah. Still owns Challenger Town, still runs it, and we still go over there and we help out with the kids, and we actually sponsor the league as well, so all the kids play for free where I'm from.
Wow, that's amazing.
You've got to be one of the few players in the world, let alone in the Premier League,
who
has the crest of a club tattooed on you. That's not the club you play for.
Yeah.
When did you get that?
Calf, isn't it? Actually, when you look at it, my calf's pathetic.
Yeah, hold on a minute.
How dare you? How dare you?
But is it a lifelong ambition that one day you will play for Birmingham City?
Nah, not that, nah. It's too much stress. I get pressure, more pressure than Blues players do when they play Villa, and I've never played for them.
Is it better to stay away from all the Birmingham clubs?
Yeah, I'm just trying to enjoy what I've got. This journey was never for me, and it's actually a story, you wouldn't know this, but my brother used to play for Villa from the age of 6 to 20, and he got injured, and you just signed from Southampton.
Yeah.
And I took him in. Remember, he used to get beans and a Yazoo, didn't they?
Yeah.
So again, from where we're from, used to come in and rob the Yazoos. Yeah. We couldn't afford them, so...
I never got a Yazoo. I wondered what.
It's all in my mum's Sierra. We went in there, and I literally... You was the first person... You walked past, and we were sat on the little seats, and I just saw your knees here, and I was like, who's that giraffe? Little did I know. Peter Crouch. And yeah, that was literally just my first encounter.
Really, yeah?
You said hello, and I was like, oh, thank you. Oh. You looked after my brother, so yeah, massively appreciate it.
Oh, God, that's nice.
This is the first proper conversation we've ever had. We've saw each other in passing, naturally, from playing, but no one ever has a bad thing to say about him, and I'll be the first to say that. He's a genuinely top bloke, so...
Can I ask, the name Troy, have you ever said to your mum, what are your siblings called?
So, do you remember... It's Troy Tempest off Thunderbirds, I think it is.
Yeah.
That's where she got the name from.
Really?
Yeah, I was gutted when I found that. I thought it was like, like Brad Pitt and Troy. I'm like, oh, it's got to be something like that, anyway.
Have you got a sister called Penelope?
It's killed me.
So you didn't fancy a Thunderbird on the back?
No, it wouldn't have had the same impact.
So what are your siblings called?
Ellis, Sasha, Joel, Caden.
And are they symbolic of anything?
Nah, they just got better names. My mum's had a bit more